Tyler from Allen Eds, wanted to show you guys this 2019 Trail Boss. It's got a few things done to it. First off, we have the Amp Research Power Steps. Do this on a lot of trucks. We did a Pace Edwards electronic bed cover on this as well. We did a full Alpine and Rockford Fosgate sound system. We actually did Alpine Type X speakers front and rear. We also did the Alpine's new processor. We did the Micro Rockford Fosgate Power Series T750 and the T400. And the Shallow Series T-Series subwoofer as well. Besides the Pace Edwards electronic bed cover and the Amp Research Power Steps, we also did the Visual Logic headrests. From the front, they look completely factory. I'll show you guys a back view too. So what kid would not love having a truck like this? You have the full gaming section of it, full apps, also have the DVD player from the back. You can also actually open these bad boys up, slide it out. Like I said, you can actually fully control it from here without actually having it even docked. As soon as you dock it, it's gonna go into the big screen mode. Now it's gonna show like that, just so it's easier to work. So like I said, DVD player from the back, you have the full Google Play Store, you have the DVD mode right there, you have gaming tabs, full apps, everything. So behind the rear seats, we actually wanted to retain as much space as we can get. So you see the two Rockford amplifiers there, the T750X1 and the T400x4. The 10 inches actually underneath this in a full size box. The Alpine processors in this segmented piece, we can actually open it up and get to just for, you know, serviceability. The factory rear seat storage compartment was actually about half the size and half the depth. So not only did you get this custom built sub box for it that looks factory, you're also actually retaining more space, a deeper space, and actually more surface area as well too. Well, that's it guys. Again, this 2019 Trail Boss came out really nice, a dream truck out of the factory, let alone with all these upgraded add-ons. Full Alpine and Rockford system, Visual Logic tablets, electronic bed cover, and the Amp Research side steps. Definitely came out really nice, guys. Make sure you follow us on Instagram and YouTube, AE South Bay on Instagram and YouTube. Give us a call, 310-542-5588.
At Rydeen, we were the first ones to actually come out with a blind spot detection kit that installs on the outside of a vehicle. Inside the kit, we have our audible speaker that's adjustable for different volumes. Also includes visual alerts, LED indicators that go on the left or right side of the dashboard, and they illuminate orange when a vehicle is approaching on either left or right side. The main control box is the piece that puts everything together and allows us to write our software to give you a kit that works great. Our GPS antenna is the piece, the key that actually helps us take a lot of false alerts away and only give you alerts when you're driving 20 miles an hour or greater. This is the license plate bar itself. So it can be flipped either way, so either at the bottom of a tag plate or the top of a license or tag plate. Slotted screws so you're not blocking state name, registration. The front is fully paintable in case you want to paint this to match vehicle color or specific want or need. So at Rydeen, we try to always go above and beyond, making sure that our product is universal. And what I mean by universal is that this product does really well in the sense that we've designed a product to work on most vehicles that are on the road today.
What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds wanted to talk about the differences between a component system and a coaxial system, and what does that all mean? You're going to see a lot of different speakers ask if it's going to be a component or a coaxial, and honestly, you have to go out to the vehicles to obviously confirm. But first and foremost, a component system means that there's going to be a mid driver and a tweeter that's separated either with a cap or the crossover. A coaxial means that you have the tweeter built in all together inside the mid driver. Advantages, disadvantages. The coaxial is going to be safe or space saving. You're going to have, again, the tweeter built into the mid driver, so no separate crossover, no separate tweeter. The advantages with the component is they're obviously going to sound better. Disadvantages is obviously separate tweeter, more space, a little bit more wiring, and obviously they're going to cost a little bit more. Crossover and what are the functions of it? So a crossover is going to take full range input either off of an aftermarket amplifier, a factory radio, aftermarket radio, and it's going to split it between a mid-bass signal for your speaker or woofer and your tweeter. So that's all it pretty much does. You're going to see the kind of inner workings of it. We have a couple up here too as well. You can kind of see it has little caps and filters. So it's going to take the input. It's going to take the input, send it to the woofer, split it, and the tweeter. It also gives you a little bit of adjustment too on the tweeter side. If you feel like your tweeters are what we call a little too bright, and the tweeters are a little harsh or a little bit high, you can actually tone them down a little bit too. That's pretty much it, guys. Thank you for checking it out. This is Tyler from Allen Eds, and please subscribe. Check us out on Instagram at AE South Bay and give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thank you. What's up, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to show you guys how to wirelessly connect wireless CarPlay for the AVIC W8400 and 8500. It's also going to work on the AVH W4400 and 4500 as well too. So I'm just going to plug in. I'm going to show you guys the plugged in method first. I'm going to plug it in. You're going to see it's going to say allow CarPlay with AVIC while locked. We're going to press allow. It's going to also ask you to enable wireless CarPlay. We're going to press allow. So as soon as I disconnect it, it's going to show that it's not there. If I go in here, or if you power cycle it, it'll do the same thing too. It should reconnect. And there it is, guys. Like I said, that's one way to do the registration or the pairing is going to be through the wired. We're going to show you guys wireless now. Let me delete everything off my phone real quick. Right now we're going to start from scratch. I'm just going to pair the phone up. So I'm going to go here. I'm going to find the phone. I'm going to find the Bluetooth for it. I'm going to press pair. So that's going to be connected. From here it's going to say use CarPlay with the 8400. I'm going to press use CarPlay. Obviously there's no cord connected to it. It's going to take a second to connect over. You can also check to make sure the Wi-Fi is paired up. It is. Give it 1 second just to finish, and then we're going to be able to do wireless CarPlay again, not being plugged in. Cord down here. There you go, guys. Like I said, there's wireless CarPlay without using the cord. Two different ways to set it up. I prefer the plugged in method. It's going to make it a lot easier, much easier to work. But yeah, from here, like I said, you can actually go through, do whatever you need to do, go to your phone, whatever. It's all there. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, AE South Bay. Like and subscribe. If you guys have any questions, give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thank you. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about windshield-mounted radars. We carry the Escort line here. They're one of the best on the market, if not the best. This is going to be the 360C. Let's open this bad boy up. Little travel case in case you guys want to move them around between vehicles. This is actually going to be the unit itself. One of the big differences besides the antenna strength is going to be the physical appearance between the 360 and the 360C. The 360C has this nice copper kind of aluminum finish to it versus the 360 is actually a solid black. I actually have one in one of my own personal cars. Can't count the amount of times this thing saved me. This is going to be the standard cord if you wanted to just plug it into the cigarette lighter. That's what a lot of people do. Over here at Allen Eds, obviously, we actually hardwire them. That's the way to do it. You stick the key in the ignition, you turn the car on, this thing's on with it. Besides that, it actually has what they have an app called Escort Live. Works out really good. It's going to allow you to touch into the community, very similar to Waze, where it'll actually help you spot and locate different things. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about probably the most exciting CarPlay unit on the market, the ILX W650. It's going to be the cheapest CarPlay Android Auto unit with a full 7-inch capacitive touchscreen. These things sold out instantly as soon as they hit the market. We got some more coming back in now. One of the cool things about it is the depth of it. Well, that's it, guys. Like I said, full 7-inch display. Really like how the buttons are actually built into the bezel. It's really shallow, as you guys can see. One of the other cool things about this specific radio is they actually have a specific amplifier that mounts to the back of it, meaning the amplifier and the radio is the same size as a standard double DIN radio. So any car that a double DIN can fit in, you can actually fit the amplifier and this without taking up any more space. Besides that, like I said, SiriusXM compatible Bluetooth radio, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, $299. Can't beat it. If you guys have any questions, give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thanks, guys. Guys, it's Tyler from Allen Ed South Bay. Wanted to show you guys the new floating ILX F309 from Alpine. It's actually the first 9-inch display that's designed to fit in a singleton chassis. Cool thing about this unit is it is mechless, so no CD or DVD, but it does do the Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Let me show you what's going on with it. So we do have AM and FM radio. We do have Bluetooth as well, and as soon as you plug in your phone, this is Apple CarPlay. So right now, you have the full mapping capabilities. Right here again, the address is right there, 17007 Hawthorne Boulevard. You also are able to do phone calls from it as well as voiceover texting. If you have Pandora or Spotify as well, it'll also show up on here. Also have MLB the At-Bat for all you Dodger fans and Angel fans in the area. You can check live score updates. Well, that's it, guys. If you guys have any further questions, give us a call at 310-542-5588. Thank you, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to introduce you guys to the Blackview lineup. They're pretty much the best dash camera on the market right now. This is their current model, the DR750O2S, the two-channel. It actually is 60 frames per second, full 1080p. Again, being a two-channel, meaning front and rear camera. This is what the camera looks like. Very small and compact. It's going to fit beautifully behind a mirror. It's the back side of it. It's the back camera. Has the cover on it too. One's just behind. Again, very small and compact. Let's check out all the accessories that come with this Blackview camera. Cigarette lighter adapter, the 12-volt power source. Front to rear camera data cable. Micro SD to USB adapter. Pry tool. All the extra pieces you need, including an extra sticky back. That's gonna be it, guys. Thanks. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to introduce you guys to Blackview's brand new 4K DR900S2 channel. So it's going to look very similar to our last DR750 camera unboxing. All the same parts. Cameras actually look virtually identical as well too, but again, built in, you know, all built in technology. They're going to look very similar. Fun fact as well too, guys, on these cameras, they actually have a shortcut on the voice deactivation, so if you don't want to have your voice activated, you take two fingers and swipe on the side and it'll actually cut the voice recording too. Something we probably haven't talked about before, and probably a lot of the guys that have the Blackview camera systems don't know. Obviously, if you come to Allen Eds, we'll explain how to use your camera system properly. And then here's the rear as well too. The rear camera is actually a little bit smaller. It's noticeably smaller for sure, actually. We also will still be using the PowerMagic Pro 2 piece like we were talking about last video too, that allows the car to not have the battery fully depleted but still allow it to record in park mode as well. Like I said, this is going to be a great camera. Retail point's actually $479, so it's not too much higher, about $80 higher than last year's model. But again, this is going to be 4K too, so if you guys do any beautiful road trips or want to get any YouTube vlogging done or anything like that, depending on what you want to use this for, this camera definitely is a marketplace for a lot of people. Well, that's it, guys. Let me know if you guys have any further questions. You guys can check us out on YouTube, Instagram at AE South Bay, or call them to the store 310-542-5588. Thanks, guys. What's going on, guys? It's Tyler from Allen Eds South Bay. Wanted to introduce you guys to our two different lines of radar detection that we have here at Allen Eds. Radar detection will let you know if there are certain radar bands that are playing that are used by either local law enforcement or, you know, different things as well. There's two real main styles between both companies. There are windshield mount ones, which are going to be a more cost effective, that will just detect radar and let you know. There's also fully installed ones that give you separate controllers. This is going to be a more discreet solution, as well as it also will do laser receiving and diffusing as well. So the big difference between them is the windshield mount ones just detect. The other fully installed one will also diffuse. The fully installed diffused one is for off-highway use only. Got to make that clear. Again, off-highway use only. Well, that's pretty much it, guys. If you guys have any further questions about any specific models, give us a call. 310-542-5588. Thank you, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to introduce you guys to Reviver Auto's new R plate. So this is actually going to be a digital license plate. You'll see it actually has white and black backlighting, so you can change it with a white background to black writing. It'll also change right now too, so it'll show your full license plate. There's the black on white. It'll also show when your tags are due, so December of whatever year is behind that plate. It'll also let you know, again, little messages underneath. It says supporting our troops. As soon as the car has been stolen, you notify the police. It'll actually show on the top where California is. It'll show stolen. For the first 90 days, you can have a, you know, appropriate image that has been certified by the company show up. So you'll see in a minute we have the Allen Eds business insignia on display as well too. You can have different images like that show up. Again, these retail at about $799. They're going to be a very cool option. They're only legal in the rear right now only. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thank you.
We'll be right back. yeah. Rolling up to the frat house and we about to rock it. Get them ladies on the dance floor, about to drop it. Once the music starts, we ain't never gonna stop it. Listen real close, man, all you hear is gossip. Drunk. Straight A student, now she looking starstruck. It's the last verse, but you know we'll never stop it. Love it too much, man, always wanna talk shit. Ladies all around, keep it going, they will not quit. This is all the shit I hear, man, call it gossip.
under the touch, dead in the eyes. No signs of life no more. I put your love under the knife. Leave me to die here all alone. No signs of life no more, no. A crying dove may never fly. It's only right for all I know. It's only matter. It's calico. It's black and white. Just let me go. It's only right for all I know. It's only matter. It's calico. It's black and white. White.
South Bay. So you want to make sure to get the window nice and wet with the soapy water so that you don't scratch it. We cut the piece of window film out to the size of the glass and start cutting it down. Next, it's time to prep the window for install. We take again our flat razor blade and scrape the inside of the window. Then we use our yellow squeegee, squeegee it clean. And the most important step is to take a white towel and towel the edges. Then we spray the bottom 3/4 of the glass. We go over to our pattern up on the glass. We spray the top quarter of the pattern after peeling the liner down 3/4 of the way. And now we're ready to install it. So we put up the glass and line the top of the pattern with the top of the glass. We leave a little bit of a gap so that as the window rolls up and down, the film won't peel. This is called the nickel. And we'll spray the glass underneath it to knock out all the debris. and we use our Blue Max to squeegee out the water. Once we've squeegeed out all the water from the film, we use our yellow car to make sure the bottom slays down under the gasket, and we're ready to clean the window off because we're done.
What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about the new CMHD4 from Rydeen. It's actually going to be very familiar to a lot of the other cameras that you guys have seen here before. It's going to look very familiar. Same size as the CMHD3, except now it's a metal housing, almost like the CMHD2. So they went back to the true metal housing. The other unique thing about the CMHD4 from Rydeen is it actually has a full new harness as well. It actually has an ignition and a reverse together. So you actually, for a lot of front camera installs that we do, stuff like that, you normally have to find your own ignition and run it. This actually allows you to pass it through, which is pretty nice. Again, metal housing, they're serial numbered too, so you can actually see the serial number on this guy. It says the model number as well too, but they're all serial number engraved. Again, metal housing versus the plastic as well. The traditional mirror and parking line lines, so green's always parking line, you cut it, you lose the parking lines. This is going to mirror the image as well too. It's a very high res camera, very nice camera. That's pretty much it. Thank you. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Onids. Wanted to talk to you guys about the SBV10WRA. It's a underseat sub solution underneath the front passenger seat in any four-door Jeeps from 07 to 18. It's a full 10-inch truck style woofer from Alpine. Really nice piece. Again, it's without giving up any space. It's actually the best of both worlds. Getting a lot of bass performance without, again, giving up any space in the cargo area in the back. The other nice thing about it too, has nice clearance, branded Alpine on the top, as well as on the side too. Fits perfectly underneath there without being mounted. The seat actually being bolted down will actually hold this thing in place. The seat actually will fully slide as well too. The other nice thing about it too is it actually comes with a weather resistant Molex style connector that you can actually disconnect and connect. $349 retail piece, guys. It's a really nice part from Alpine. Perfect solution without giving up any space. If you guys want it, give us a call, 310-542-5588. How's it going, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about vinyl. We're actually a full dealer for Avery Dennison as well as 3M. We like using the Avery Dennison film as well as the 3M 1080. With that, we have full solutions in every, you know, texture, shade, color, chromes. Also, the color flows are big too, so we actually have some. This is going to be the Lightning Ridge. It's actually going to go from a purple to green. I don't know if you guys can see that on the camera, depending on the way the light hits it. Same thing with 3M too. This is the 1080, so you actually have their chrome. They have some really nice, so this is that deep metallic blue. It's a really nice color too. And we have that textured camo. They have their version of, it's called Matrix. It's actually going to be like a hive pattern. This is their carbon fiber. They have silver and they have white carbon fiber as well too. We also do full chrome deletes. We do full vehicle wraps. We do anything that you guys could ever want. So if you guys have any questions, give us a call, 310-542-5588. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. We're here with the Alpine Tacoma. Really excited to have it out here at our Alpine Experience Day. It's happening today, Tuesday, May 7th. Anyways, like I said, with this Tacoma, it's featuring all Alpine product, X-Series everything, featuring an Alpine ILX F309 radio with sort of the Alpine processor. You can see the actual controller for the processor right there. X-Series amps with a 12-inch ported box. This thing sounds really good for sure. The tuning on it's done really good. It sounds really good for even having a ported box. There you go, you can see the three amplifiers right there. Thing sounds really good. Like I said, looks clean. You're not gonna see anything from behind there. And even me, I got to sit in this thing before. It doesn't feel too uncomfortable having that sub right there, guys. Talk to you guys about this 2015 Challenger RT we have here. This is actually gonna be featuring airlift suspension as well as R-Series and X-Series equipment. It's gonna be R-Series speakers around the entire vehicle, 6x9 components in the front, 6.5s on the rear deck, X-Series amps and R-Series subs like we were talking. 212s, full custom show trunk. A lot of time and, you know, dedication and energy went into this vehicle. Came out really nice. Like I said, I think it's a beautiful setup. You're gonna see the airlift suspension here with the color matched lines, black compressors, black tank. Really goes with this trunk. Had a lot of people walk by and check it out today and go, wow, as soon as it opens up. Like I said, system sounds really good. Also, if you guys look, this thing is slammed. I know the customer was talking about putting a supercharger from Kennebell on it too. This thing's gonna be around a lot, guys. It's gonna be one of our cars we're gonna have at a lot of shows. It's definitely a unique car. This thing is on the ground. I just wanted to talk to you guys about this Chrysler Pacifica that is a wheelchair access vehicle, as you guys can see. The customer came into us, wanted a sound system to trick it out. He had some wheels on here too. I think they're Verde wheels. Besides that, we did a full Alpine system featuring R and X series equipment. We have R series speakers and subs around the full vehicle. We have X series amps, and the one cool thing you're gonna notice about the beauty panel that we built for it, all the equipment's actually color matched. All the trim off the Alpine amp we sent out, we got it matched to that tan interior. Definitely a unique look, goes good with that box that we did black against the tan there too, featuring a full size R series sub. 12-inch. Like I said, this thing definitely racks. It sounds really good for what it is. Customer cannot be more ecstatic about it. Like I said, guys, this is going to be the Chrysler Pacifica that we did with all Alpine X Series and R Series. Came out really good, guys. Guys, stay tuned for more content here at Allen Ed's South Bay, AE South Bay on Instagram, and AE South Bay on YouTube. Thanks again, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Ed's. Wanted to talk to you guys about an install we have currently in the Bay. It's a 2000 Porsche 911 Carrera. These cars, even when they were brand new, were severely lacking in the features that a lot of these modern cars have. There's this thing about a lot of these Porsche European cars that they're 10 years behind. A lot of these cars only pretty much came with CD and AM/FM radios. So this, we're actually putting Pioneer's new wireless AVH W4400 radio. It's going to do wireless Apple CarPlay, has Android Auto as well, HD tuner, SiriusXM capability, and front and rear cameras as well. We're also going to be modernizing the Bose system in there too. We're going to leave the existing factory Bose amplifier, but we're going to be changing out to Focal Access three-way components. So we have the 6.5-inch mid-drivers that are going to be going in each door. We also have the 3-inch mid-range and the tweet that's going to be going up on the dash in the same factory locations. Everything's going to look exactly the same as it did factory besides the screen. So we have the 6.5-inch mid right here. We have the 3-inch mid-range, that's why it's called a three-way right there. So it's going to go up on the dash. And we have the traditional tweeter. The other thing you're going to notice too is the crossover block. So instead of just having an input, woofer and tweet, so you have your input right here. You have your woofer, meaning the 6.5-inch. We have the mid-range, meaning the 3, and then the tweeter up top. Let's go see how the car is turning out now. I believe he's in disassembly phase. Let's go see what's going on. What's going on, guys? It's Tyler from Allen Ed's. Wanted to talk to you guys about Alpine, one of the leaders in the 12-volt industry. As far as what they do, they make aftermarket radios, they make aftermarket amplifiers, they make aftermarket speakers, subwoofers, they make digital sound processors. They also make a ILX F309, which is their new mechless 9-inch standing halo unit. That's a singleton chassis mount that gives you the full 9-inch display. But back to what they're doing, they're making Apple CarPlay and Android Auto units. They're kind of going away from built-in CD and DVD. So all their units now are actually mechless, meaning no CD or DVD, but they have the full 7-inch display. This one's gonna be wired CarPlay and Android Auto with Bluetooth. This is the ILX 207. They also make the ILX 107 that's gonna be wireless CarPlay enabled. But what Alpine's really best known for is just really great bang for your buck. Speakers, amplifiers, and all sorts of different stereo equipments. If you go over to the Alpine Type X, They're going to be pretty much as far as top of the line amplifiers go until you get into high-end car audio. So the X series amplifiers are great. The 2-ohm rated mono block will make 900 RMS. The 4-channel will actually make 120 watts by 4. So like I said, for the price of having about $500 to $600 amplifiers, they're great for what they are. Same thing with the speakers too. Alpine makes even cheaper speakers, the Type E. We're not going to go into details with that, but they make the Alpine Type S, which are a great factory upgrade. Again, between $100 to $129 for the speakers, depending on what size. And that even goes for the 6.5-inch component. You have one more step up. You have the Alpine Type R's, which go from $200 for the coaxial to $299 for the component. And then you go up to the Type X, which is now their new top of the line that they're bringing back for 2018. Alpine's also leading the forefront in factory premium upgraded systems. You still have brands like Bang & Olufsen, Infiniti, Meridian, stuff like that, but Alpine's really pushing the Jeep market as well as a few different things, and they're actually the premium upgrade for, again, the Jeep Wranglers and other, you know, Dodge Chrysler products such as the Challengers, the Chargers. If you get the upgraded premium system, it actually comes with the Alpine system. That being said, guys, this is Tyler from Allen Eds. Give us a call, 302-542-5588. Thank you. What's up, guys? It's Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about this 2015 Challenger RT we have here. This is actually going to be featuring airlift suspension as well as R-Series and X-Series equipment. It's going to be R-Series speakers around the entire vehicle, 6x9 components in the front, 6.5s on the rear deck, X-Series amps, and R-Series subs like we were talking. 212s, full custom show trunk. A lot of time and, you know, dedication and energy went into this vehicle. Came out really nice. Like I said, I think it's a beautiful setup. You're gonna see the airlift suspension here with the color matched lines, black compressors, black tank, really goes with this trunk. Had a lot of people walk by and check it out today and go, wow, as soon as it opens up. Like I said, system sounds really good. Also, if you guys look, this thing is slammed. I know the customer was talking about putting a supercharger from Kennebell on it too. This thing's gonna be around a lot, guys. It's gonna be one of our cars. We're gonna have a lot of shows. It's definitely a unique car. This thing is on the ground. Check us out on AE South Bay for our Instagram, AE South Bay for our YouTube, and Allen Eds South Bay for our Facebook. Thanks again, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about probably the most exciting CarPlay unit on the market, the ILX W650. It's gonna be the cheapest CarPlay Android Auto unit with a full 7-inch capacitive touchscreen. These things sold out instantly as soon as they hit the market. We got some more coming back in now. One of the cool things about it is the depth of it. Well, that's it, guys. Like I said, full 7-inch display. Really like how the buttons are actually built into the bezel. It's really shallow, as you guys can see. One of the other cool things about this specific radio is they actually have a specific amplifier that mounts to the back of it, meaning the amplifier and the radio is the same size as a standard double DIN radio. So any car that double DIN can fit in, you can actually fit the amplifier and this without taking up any more space. Besides that, like I said, SiriusXM compatible Bluetooth radio, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, $299. Can't beat it. If you guys have any questions, give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thanks, guys. Hey guys, what's up? It's Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about this Chrysler Pacifica that is a wheelchair access vehicle, as you guys can see. The customer came into us, wanted a sound system to trick it out. He had some wheels on here too. I think they're Verde wheels. Besides that, we did a full Alpine system featuring R and X series equipment. We have R series speakers and subs around the full vehicle. We have X series amps, and the one cool thing you're gonna notice about the beauty panel that we built for it, all the equipment's actually color matched. All the trim off the Alpine amp we sent out, we got it matched to that tan interior. Definitely a unique look, goes good with that box that we did black against the tan there too, featuring a full size R series sub. 12-inch, like I said, this thing definitely racks. It sounds really good for what it is. Customer cannot be more ecstatic about it. Like I said, guys, this is going to be the Chrysler Pacifica that we did with all Alpine X Series and R Series. Came out really good, guys. Guys, stay tuned for more content here at Allen Eds South Bay, AE South Bay on Instagram, and AE South Bay on YouTube. Thanks again, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about the SBV10 WRA. It's a underseat sub solution underneath the front passenger seat in any four-door Jeeps from 07 to 18. It's a full 10-inch truck-style woofer from Alpine. Really nice piece. Again, it's without giving up any space. It's actually the best of both worlds. Getting a lot of bass performance without, again, giving up any space in the cargo area in the back. The other nice thing about it, too, has nice clearance. Branded Alpine on the top as well as on the side, too. Fits perfectly underneath there without being mounted. The seat actually being bolted down will actually hold this thing in place. The seat actually will fully slide as well too. The other nice thing about it too is it actually comes with a weather resistant Molex style connector that you can actually disconnect and connect. $349 retail piece, guys. It's a really nice part from Alpine. Perfect solution without giving up any space. If you guys want it, give us a call, 310-542-5588. How's it going, guys? It's Tyler from Allen Ed South Bay. Wanted to show you guys the new floating ILX F309 from Alpine. It's actually the first 9-inch display that's designed to fit in a singleton chassis. Cool thing about this unit is it is mechless, so no CD or DVD, but it does do the Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Let me show you what's going on with it. So we do have AM and FM radio. We do have Bluetooth as well. And as soon as you plug in your phone, this is Apple CarPlay. So right now you have the full mapping capabilities. Right here again, the address is right there, 17007 Hawthorne Boulevard. You also are able to do phone calls from it as well as voice over texting. If you have Pandora or Spotify as well, it will also show up on here. Also have MLB the At-Bat for all you Dodger fans and Angel fans in the area. You can check live score updates. Well, that's it, guys. If you guys have any further questions, give us a call at 310-542-5588. Thank you, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about the PXE0850S. It's Alpine's new processor. We've done a lot of processors here at Allen Eds South Bay. We've done the Rockford 360 series. We've done Focal's processor. We've done a lot of stuff from Audison. This is by far our favorite processor, and at the price point, I think it's probably the best on the market too. Let's open this bad boy up. It has a separate controller, so this is gonna be the cable for that. The instructions and stuff like that. Right there, guys, again, that's the Alpine processor. It's got three RCA inputs as well as high level input. You can also actually run Bluetooth streaming straight into it. You can also run optical and SPDIF. The other thing you can also do, well, it also has six RCA pre-outs, and it'll also do high level as well too, and SPDIF out. The nice thing about this piece again is the price point. It's got Bluetooth built in with a separate chip. I'll show you guys that right now. You don't have to use it. It's gonna be the plug back here. But yeah, you can use it, you don't have to use it. It's a nice standalone piece you can flush in the dash. Here's that Bluetooth streaming chip, and actually you'll see us plug it in right now. Like I said, the other nice thing about it too is you can use this as a source, you can use this as a standalone, you can use this as a radio replacement. Alpine actually came out with their own first 8-inch woofer with DSP built in with Bluetooth, so actually you can actually use that as an all-in-one audio upgrade. Like I said, this is Alpine's PXE0850S. It's going to be one of the best DSP on the markets for the price. Again, at a retail price point of $699, guys, you can't beat it. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. It's this time of year again. New product is unveiled. So this is going to be two new series of equipment from Alpine. We have the R-Series RS65.2. These are actually going to be a real nice speaker. Just from opening them up and checking them out, they actually look very familiar. They look kind of like the X series. Because now they're high res rated. These look oddly familiar. The tweeter actually looks identical to what the X series used to look like as well. Same thing with the surround. So I think the technology kind of fell off on that one. There you go, the RS65.2. Also, replacing the MRV F300 is now the SA32F. It's actually a really nice amp. It's actually 2-ohm stable now. It'll even do up to 80 watts. It's 55 watts at 4-ohm. If you guys are interested in any of the stuff in the new S-Series amps or the new R-Series speakers, you know where to get them. Allen Ed South Bay, give us a call, 310-542-5588. How's it going, guys? It's Tyler from Allen Ed South Bay. Wanted to show you guys the new floating ILX F309 from Alpine. It's actually the first 9-inch display that's designed to fit in a singleton chassis. Cool thing about this unit is it is mechless, so no CD or DVD, but it does do the Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Let me show you what's going on with it. So we do have AM and FM radio. We do have Bluetooth as well. And as soon as you plug in your phone, this is Apple CarPlay. So right now, you have the full mapping capabilities. Right here again, the address is right there, 17007 Hawthorne Boulevard. You also are able to do phone calls from it as well as voiceover texting. If you have Pandora or Spotify as well, it'll also show up on here. Also have MLB the At-Bat for all you Dodger fans and Angel fans in the area. You can check live score updates. Well, that's it, guys. If you guys have any further questions, give us a call at 310-542-5588. Thank you, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Onids. Wanted to talk to you guys about the SBV10WRA. It's a underseat sub solution underneath the front passenger seat in any four-door Jeeps from 07 to 18. It's a full 10-inch truck-style woofer from Alpine. Really nice piece. Again, it's without giving up any space. It's actually the best of both worlds. Getting a lot of bass performance without, again, giving up any space in the cargo area in the back. The other nice thing about it too, has nice clearance, branded Alpine on the top, as well as on the side too. Fits perfectly underneath there without being mounted. The seat actually being bolted down will actually hold this thing in place. The seat actually will fully slide as well too. The other nice thing about it too is it actually comes with a weather resistant Molex style connector that you can actually disconnect and connect. $349 retail piece, guys. It's a really nice part from Alpine. Perfect solution without giving up any space. If you guys want it, give us a call, 310-542. How's it going, guys? It's Tyler from Allen Ed South Bay. Wanted to show you guys the new floating ILX F309 from Alpine. It's actually the first 9-inch display that's designed to fit in a singleton chassis. Cool thing about this unit is it is mechless, so no CD or DVD, but it does do the Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Let me show you what's going on with it. So we do have AM and FM radio. We do have Bluetooth as well. And as soon as you plug in your phone, this is Apple CarPlay. So right now you have the full mapping capabilities. Right here again, the address is right there, 17007 Hawthorne Boulevard. You also are able to do phone calls from it as well as voice over texting. If you have Pandora or Spotify as well, it will also show up on here. Also have MLB the At-Bat for all you Dodger fans and Angel fans in the area. You can check live score updates. Well, that's it, guys. If you guys have any further questions, give us a call at 310-542-5588. Thank you, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about probably the most exciting CarPlay unit on the market, the ILX W650. It's going to be the cheapest CarPlay Android Auto unit with a full 7-inch capacitive touchscreen. These things sold out instantly as soon as they hit the market. We got some more coming back in now. One of the cool things about it is the depth of it. Well, that's it, guys. Like I said, full 7-inch display. Really like how the buttons are actually built into the bezel. It's really shallow, as you guys can see. One of the other cool things about this specific radio is they actually have a specific amplifier that mounts to the back of it, meaning the amplifier and the radio is the same size as a standard double DIN radio. So any car that a double DIN can fit in, you can actually fit the amplifier and this without taking up any more space. Besides that, like I said, SiriusXM compatible Bluetooth radio, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, $299. Can't beat it. If you guys have any questions, give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thanks, guys. What's up, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about the KTA 450. Reason why we're bringing this up is because we just did a video on the ILX W650. A lot of people had a lot more questions, called in, placed orders for that radio. So I wanted to talk to you guys about the KTA 450. This is going to be the matching amplifier for it. That actually is a dual stack. It actually mounts to the back of this radio. Get the harness in there, the USB, everything. Like I said, then the KTA 450 goes and stacks on top of it. And this thing is a true depth double DIN. So without giving up any space at all, you have a true depth double DIN that's going to be giving you the cheapest and best CarPlay unit on the market at $299 with a matching amplifier for $500 basically. So for the package price of $499 plus install and parts, guys, you're going to have a 50 watt per channel, 4-channel, and an Apple CarPlay capacitive 7-inch display. Like I said, guys, if you guys have any other questions, give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thank you, guys. What's going on, guys? Tal from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about Alpine's ILX 107. Very popular unit when they first came out. They're kind of getting a second wave too. $699 unit, wireless CarPlay enabled unit. It's going to do AM FM radio as well as auxiliary Bluetooth and CarPlay. See all the wires and everything labeled there. You get the USB connection. Just because all the wireless CarPlay units still can be hardwired in, so you still can plug in to do CarPlay. You don't have to do it wirelessly, so it'll still charge the phone. Here's the unit right here, guys. So again, just pretty much wireless CarPlay, wired CarPlay, AM FM, as well as Bluetooth and auxiliary. Also has a rear camera input as well too. But like I said, really nice unit, guys. We sell a lot of them, really happy with them. Kind of getting their second wave back in. It's about a year old now at this point, but 107, 207 Alpine units are still doing really good, guys. Thanks again. Hey guys, what's going on? It's Tyler from Allen Eds. I wanted to show you guys how to set up a Bluetooth hands-free calling device on the newer CDE-172. You're gonna go to where it says Bluetooth. It'll normally start off with General. You're gonna scroll past Audio, Display, and you're gonna tap Bluetooth, and you'll see a function that says Pairing. You're gonna hit that. You're gonna select the Set Device 2 or Set Device 1. And it's going to go into Bluetooth pairing. You're going to be able to confirm that with the Bluetooth icon in the corner beeping. You're going to see it blink, and once you select it, it'll now show up and it'll be paired up. If you have any further questions, give me a call, 310-542-5588.
Welcome to the Back Bay. A lot of you guys never really get to see what goes on behind the scenes. Customers bring in vehicles, see the finished product. Well, today, going to open up, shed some light. So we got a beautiful BMW, nice little classic here, M Roadster. We're gonna be upgrading the client's radio because she wants to have Bluetooth and all the new amenities and everything that's cool with the new Alpine radios, especially this one has CarPlay features. But in order to do that, the first thing you really have to do is make sure you look up the make, the model and everything, try to get the right harness. Now in the situation that we had here earlier, we ordered up a harness and the harness is giving us distortion, so we're trying something else. But the basic necessities in order to get a radio installed, you got the radio harness and you got the factory adapter harness. We have black as a ground, yellow in most instance is the constant wire for memory to keep the radio stations, the clock, things like that, memory for radio settings, tuning settings and stuff. Not too many cars will offer this cable, and this wire right here is actually for illumination. So when you turn on the factory dash, it changes the illumination on a radio. Then of course, factory amplifier or factory powered antenna. So these need to get connected first. A lot of times you have to solder it or, you know, makes a better connection, but in this case, use some high barrel connectors as we call them. Give it a nice little crimp, twist the wires, make sure it's nice and clean, insert the butt connector, crimp, it's pretty much wash, rinse and repeat until all the harness is done. It's important to twist these wires up before you crimp them.
Okay, got it.
Nice and tight, so that when we insert the butt connector and we crimp it, there's no stragglers. You don't see any loose cabling coming out that could cause a fire, cause something to malfunction or any issues like that. So once we have that, we'll move on to this one. Now, since this is only one blue wire, we're only gonna be required to do one thing in this car. So what you could do is snip this wire a little shorter, and you're going to want to peel back a little bit just to cover the bare cabling so you don't have to worry about any issues later on. I like all the cables to be even, so what I'll do is I'll snip it even and then I'll start stripping away and do the same process again. You want to make sure everything's inside that barrel connector so that it can protect it. And you got to give it a good crimp. Nice and snug. Power cables, everything should be set. So what we're gonna do is do the same for all the speaker wires minus the cable that we cut short. So every vehicle and every radio, they're already color keyed, as you can see. So you just got to match them up. There's four speaker for four channels because there is an internal amp on the radio. Purple is usually for right rear. Green usually is for left rear. Gray is for front right. White, front left. So let's proceed with that. Again, they're uneven. So what I like to do next is, let's get this harness plugged up, because BMW, since there's so many variables that come into play, you wanna make sure you have the right harness. Even though we looked up the year, make, and model, a lot of times the harness itself may not match up correctly. Make sure it clicks in. See, a lot of times it gives us a little issue. Just double check everything. It's in. So before I connect the speaker wires, I want to test everything. So we'll go ahead, plug the power in since we have that done already. Grab the key. Let's close this door so it doesn't beep. Just have this ready. Find the corresponding speaker wires. And again, let's keep it clean. Twist them up nice. And then match the stripe up with the stripe. Test the audio. Okay, that one sounds good. Let's go ahead and give that a nice crimp. And move on to the next. And for you out there that's wondering, how come I just didn't connect everything at first? Again, this is a certain scenario situation. I like to hear the speaker, see if the speaker itself, individual speakers, if it's acting up, if it's blown, it might be out of phase by factory. So I like going one by one just to test it. And I also like doing it this way because once I know everything's connected correctly, I don't have to chop up the harness, I don't have to redo anything. It's efficient. And that's the rear right. Sounds good. So now what we can do is do that final crimp, turn off everything, and then clean up the harness. Since this radio does have a Bluetooth system, what we went ahead was I removed this whole paneling and then the A-pillar, ran the microphone. Since it is a convertible, I put it in an area, even though it has wind cancellation or noise cancellation, if you want to call it. This also allows it to have clear projected voice through conversations. So I ran it down, made sure everything was clean, everything's tied up like OEM. Right here, you can opt to do zip ties, you can do tape, you can do Tessa tape, the fabric tape. It's really your choice, but I just like to have everything nice and tidy and clean, so then we don't have to worry about any bad things that's gonna occur behind the radio while the customer's driving or anything like that. Once that's done, so everything's ready to go. Oh yeah, also, we get a little creative here. I found a stock location. Instead of just running the USB cable into the glove box or anywhere, I found a nice little unused panel. And then we did a USB flush mount So now the customer can actually plug their phone cable in there for the use of the CarPlay or Pandora, and it looks factory. And then if they don't like it, or if they want to take it out later on to put in another vehicle, so make sure everything's tied up, microphone's plugged in, antenna's plugged in, plug back the power, tuck everything carefully. Slide it in. Make sure you get the trim ring, because they are pretty fun to put on. And that's it. Give it a final test. But what I like about this Alpine HD149BT, it actually has some really cool crossover features. It's a very high-end singleton. So press and hold the setup button, get you into the different parameters and stuff like that. Here's the EQ, and now I can actually go adjust the frequencies, levels of what I wanna, you know, make it sound like. It's a 9-band built-in EQ. So you have so many different options to go with this. But at the end of the day, it's what sounds good to your ears. And that's it. If you have any questions, let us know. Give us a call here at AE South Bay. Make sure you catch us a follow and a like on Facebook or IG, AE South Bay.
What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Edge.
Wanted to give you guys a little walkthrough of our most popular unit here. It's going to be the ILX W650. Let's go over and check it all out. So first and foremost, you're going to see the main screen here. A lot of people don't know, you hold down the squares, unit's going to turn off. Put it back. It's back on. It's going to go back to your last set default. We can go over to radio. So it's going to be set on a radio station. If you want to hold one in, you'll see it change preset. You guys can go FM2, FM3, AM, hold it down, it'll change it. We'll go back. You obviously have the volume up, volume down, mute. Siri button's pretty cool too. I like how Alpine does that a lot too. As soon as the unit is plugged in via CarPlay to the supplied USB, you can actually hit the volume button, it'll trigger Siri, and you could ask her to do different things such as location, you know, go to different places through Apple Maps, send text messages, you know, call people, different things. It's pretty nice. The other thing it does too, no cameras hooked up. You guys can see the grid lines hooked up right now too, is if you hook up a camera that has ignition or reverse supplied, obviously when the car's in reverse, the camera image will show up. Or if you hook it up to ignition, you can actually turn the camera view on by hitting the cam button. The other nice thing about this ILX W650 is it actually has dual camera inputs. If for a lot of you lowered vehicle guys or anybody that has a long nose, Corvette, Viper owners, you guys can actually put a front camera on so you don't run it into parking blocks. And you can go to the setup as well too. So this is where you can itemize different sounds. So for most people, you can do just the standard fade and balance. This is what I really like about this unit. It's really easy to use. You got the bass, mid, treb, preset EQs, subwoofer control, so you can turn it on and off, and then the level. What I also like is you can hit advanced, and all these things change. So you can actually go to preset crossovers for different, you know, outputs, so front, rear, sub. You can do preset EQs, and then you can do time alignment as well, too. You can also do that in milliseconds, centimeters, inches, so different distances or time. So it'll calculate all that. So again, you can just, you know, do all sorts of time alignment as well. So for a $299 CarPlay unit, this thing is feature-packed. Again, Bluetooth for hands-free calling, audio streaming, SiriusXM with compatible SXV300 tuner, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, has full audio controls built in. This is a really nice unit, guys. If you guys have any questions about this thing, give us a call, 310-542-5588. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds here to talk to you guys about the HCE TCAM 1 WRA, which is going to fit all Jeep JK Wranglers that have a spare tire back there. So let's get into this thing. This thing's pretty cool. It's been out for a minute now. You guys have seen plenty of content on it. You can see the camera there. Third brake light, and there's actually a reverse up top. One of the questions people ask is, what am I gonna do if I get a flat and need to change my spare out? What's cool about this piece is it's actually just a rubber grommet, and you can actually see that there's a nut that goes behind there that locks it in. So nothing to worry about there, just a little rubber cover you gotta pop off, and it's pretty easy to take this thing off, like I said, just a single nut. And there's just a plug clip right there, comes right out. It actually has three mounting spacers, and what this is going to do is allow you, depending if you have the factory rim and tire, a little bit wider but nothing crazy, and then crazy, that's going to be the bracket that's going to bolt up. Here's the spacer that's actually going to hold the camera on it from behind. Here's the hardware. It's going to be that nut that we were talking about. And I guess they actually give you a spare rubber piece there. Didn't know that. Spare rubber. What else it's also going to do is, again, standard RCA plug, or it's going to be the universal plug. And so this actually gives you output to a factory display. So you can buy this thing for any aftermarket radio or factory. This thing's definitely a quality piece. Third brake light, reverse light, and backup camera as well. The other thing you also are going to notice if you go to our Instagram too is we actually delete the third brake lights. Like I said, this thing is definitely pretty nice. $499. If you guys are interested for any of your guys' JK stuff, any Wrangler stuff, give us a call, 309-542-5588. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. We're here with the Alpine PWD CB1, also known as the ICE, Alpine ICE. What that stands for is In Cooler Entertainment. Alpine ICE right there for you. What this thing has is it has a 5 1/4 set of component speakers with a 4x8 passive radiator on both sides, built-in Bluetooth. It'll also, again, function as an ice chest as well too. You can see inside there. It'll hold 72 cans of your favorite adult beverages, as well as full of ice too. It's got a quick drain plug on the other side, two nice handles, because this thing is heavy. This thing does weigh about 50 pounds. It's got nice rubber straps as well. The one downside to this thing though is it does require to be plugged in. So they do give you a cigarette lighter plug to keep it powered on. Again, there is no built-in battery. It is just via a plug-in. If you guys have any questions about the Alpine ICE, give us a call, 309-542-5588. Thanks, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about Diamond's D-Pass 10. It's our solution for anybody who doesn't want to give up any sort of trunk space. It's a passive radiator, 10-inch amplified, self-amplified sub. We use these in a lot of trucks. We use them in a lot of sedans. Anybody who's not looking for a crazy amount of bass, that's looking for a little bit of an upgrade without giving up or sacrificing any space. These fit right underneath the seats. The seats will slide over. Like I said, amplifier built in. You're gonna see the 8-gauge input on the side right here. The RCA input, you can actually run high level in, so you don't need a high to low, or we still recommend you use a high to low, run low level into it. You're gonna see the frequency, the bass boost, and the gain response here. You can actually turn the phase in and out. Included with the D-Pass 10 is a standalone bass knob. You're going to see the telephone jack that's going to run and actually plug in from the bass knob into the side of the unit. Thanks again, guys, for watching. Make sure you guys like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Make sure you guys check us out on Instagram at AE South Bay, Facebook at Allen Ed South Bay. Thanks again. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about this 69 Bronco we did for Kenwood and Dub Magazine. It was featured in a bunch of Kenwood videos as well as Dub Magazine. It's this nice gloss metallic gray, charcoal gray with black accents. Besides that, the other cool thing about it is it's a manual. It's got Kenwood's DNX 894S radio. It also has a custom center console that we built that features an 8-inch subwoofer in there. You're going to see custom kick panel speakers featuring Kenwood Exelon speakers there as well too. If you actually go to the back, full-size 12s, besides that 8-inch, all the Exelon series stuff, as well as an XR1000 up top, and you see an XR601, as well as an XR400, and you're powering the mids and highs. Kenwood makes really quality equipment, guys. Like I said, this thing bangs. It sounds really nice and clean at fabulous Fords. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk about one of the biggest things that customers ask. Difference between factory and aftermarket speakers. The one thing you're going to notice is all the paper. It's paper cone, very cheap foam, very small magnet, just build them as cheap as possible. I was just going to show you guys a couple of examples. This is going to be a Focal Access speaker that's going to be more matching the rear. It's going to have a tweeter built in. It's going to be one of the number one differences. The other thing is it's going to be an aluminum woven speaker, as well as the much nicer speaker. Much more magnet depth. It's going to actually last a lot longer. It's going to sound a lot better too. The front I was going to compare it to is an Infinity Kappa Perfect. It's actually made out of carbon fiber. It has a crossover not shown, but again, this thing's a much bigger magnet. Will handle a lot more power and much nicer material. It's going to sound better, last a lot longer, handle a lot more power. And same thing with the tweeters too. Like I said, this is going to be an aftermarket aluminum tweeter versus the factory too. Just much big difference as well too. One of the things too, when I talk to customers as well as installs, is what we do here at Allen Ed's is we always make an MDF trim ring, and we silicone seal our speakers to make them fit correctly. A lot of shops, as you guys can see, the speaker's not really designed to go in this opening. So what we need to do is we actually make an MDF trim template that'll actually match the size. We silicone seal it with either double stick or silicone, and we actually mount the speaker on top to actually give it that factory fit and finish, as well as the depth that it needs to clear any sort of windows or anything like that. But like I said, just to drive the point home, you can see how much cheaper the speaker is. You can see that, you know, sound quality is not the ideal with the solution, and they're just trying to do it as cost effective as possible. Versus, like I said, Focal and Infinity right here, you can see that sound quality, fit and finish is gonna be, you know, number one to anything else, and that's why you're also paying a premium. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Tyler from Allen Ed's. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. This is the Focal Access Series. They're gonna be our actual number one speaker that we sell. We sell a lot of them. They're really good sounding speakers, and you know, they're a nice addition to pretty much any system. The nice thing about them is they're very efficient. So under low amplification, even decent amplification, or even off of a stock system, they're gonna run really efficiently and sound really good. Most of these other aftermarket speakers are designed to go with aftermarket amplifiers, and some customers don't wanna go through all that. So again, just having a drop-in speaker from the Focal lineup from the Access Series, just a great lineup. Thanks for listening again, guys. This is Tyler from Allen Ed's. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Ed's. Wanted to show you guys Focal's integration lineup. They make drop-in speakers for Toyota, BMW, and Volkswagen. So these are actually for a Toyota. I have the 6x9 components, but basically the component's gonna have a separate mid-driver and tweeter with a crossover. Again, you'll see the mid-driver, the tweeter going into a Tacoma. So you have the 6x9 components in the front, 6.5 coaxials in the rear. Again, these are specifically made for a Toyota. They're gonna be designed to be on slight amplification or off of factory power, either factory amplified or off of the factory radio. They're gonna be a great speaker. They started about $299 for the component set and about $249 for the coaxial set. Like I said, for under $300, having them fit perfectly in, nice foam surround, everything goes right in, sealed nice and tight. Can't really beat it for the price. And again, with Focal's name on it, you know it's gonna be a good product. Well, that's it, guys. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Ed's here to talk to you guys about the 165YE from Focal. These are going to be very similar to the Access Series, but these are actually America-specific speakers, so you guys can't find them anywhere else, only here. Tuned a little bit better, a little bit nicer set of speakers. They're $399, so they're about $70 more than the regular Access Series. Already opened these bad boys up so you guys can see. Grills are going to be the same. Again, there's that mid with the gold there. You're going to see on the back here as well. So like I said, very similar to the normal Access 165AS, but a few distinct differences. The writing is going to be in gold on the actual crossover itself, and then it actually has a gold dust cap as well on the mid-driver. These things are flying off the shelf, guys. Again, these just came in. They're going to be something that's going to bridge the gap between the typical Access and the Flax. If you guys are interested in this, give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thanks, guys. How's it going, guys? Tyler from Allen Ed's. Wanted to talk to you guys about Rostra and specifically their comfort heated seat solution. They actually come with two kits. They have universal and vehicle specific for Toyotas and different vehicles for the heated solutions. They also have the added lumbar support. What I like about this kit is it's very easy and universal to install. And everything's gonna be like OEM. OEM style button. Again, they have two separate switches or a single kit. This is gonna be the single button with dual switches. Everything's gonna be loomed up as factory OEM as possible, but everything's fit like OEM, built like OEM for that long lasting quality, guys. If you guys are interested like in anything from Rostra, such as the lumbar support or the heated seats, you know where to get it from us at Allen Ed South Bay. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thanks, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about Kenwood's new X8025. It's going to be their new X series line. It's going to be still an Exelon unit, so it comes with a 2-year warranty. The unit's also certified high res. Show it to you guys right now too. So it looks really nice. Looks a lot different than any of their other amplifiers. It's actually even a little bit more compact, I believe. All the inputs are on one side, which makes it really easy and cleaner for install. Instead of having wiring come from top and bottom or left and right, it just all is from the bottom. So that's a nice thing about it. All the tuning and everything's done on the other side. So the high res certification actually means it's designed to play from 20 hertz all the way up to 40k. You can see it labeled right there. Besides having this brushed black finish on it, you're going to actually see the Kenwood logo light up in the middle when the amp is powered on. Again, you're going to see the Exelon logo right here, as well as the model number. Stay tuned for all of the Kenwood videos that are going to be dropping here shortly. A lot of their new product is just available and just dropping. So thanks again, guys. Tyler from Allen Eds. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about Kenwood's new DDX996XR. It's their brand new reference style radio. The biggest change for it is going to be a new interface, much faster interface, 3 camera inputs, as well as wireless CarPlay. Kenwood finally joined the party. Anyways, guys, here's going to be the unit. It's going to be a nice 6.8 inch display. Kenwood always has the nicest displays. They're 1080p. Again, really nice. If you guys are looking for a DVD player unit or looking something to go perfect with like a CMHD4 writing backup camera, this can be the best aesthetic looking screen on any, you know, out of any of the major manufacturers. That being said, moving forward, we got the extensions. So these are going to be the USB extensions. We have the microphone. We have the GPS antenna, and give us a call if you guys are interested in this unit or anything else. 310-542-5588. Check us out on Instagram, Facebook, AE South Bay on Instagram, Allen Eds South Bay on Facebook. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to show you something we were working on. It's going to be a 2008 Toyota FJ Cruiser. It's going to have an MVH 1400 NEX installed in here. It's going to be a capacitive touch. It's full. It's technically a 6.2-inch display because you have the capacitive buttons on the side, but a full doubled-in, mechless, meaning no CD, CarPlay unit. So the nice thing about this FJ is we're able to retain all the steering wheel controls. You can track forward from all the sources as well, too. One of the other factory-like things that we were able to do is retain the factory auxiliary and US key on the factory location. So with that, if when you're done using it, you can actually just pull out, close it up, and when you want to use it again, you just pop it back down. Like I said, this unit's got CarPlay, so I'll show you that right now. So we're gonna plug in. You're gonna see it show up on the display. All of our mapping, voiceover texting, got Pandora, Google Maps, Waze, Spotify, we have MLB at bat. Thanks again, guys. Stay tuned on Instagram, Facebook. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about Rockford Fosgate. We are a full authorized dealer for them. I have some of their stuff for their motorcycles. They're pretty much the go-to for anything Harley Davidson. We have it here at Allen Eds South Bay. They have drop-in pieces that require some modifications, like these bag lids over here that are going to fit the 6x9s. We have the drop-in front audio kit too for Harley Davidson, but we carry everything from their car stereo to their marine. They're also well known for a lot of their big bass packages too. They're our go-to for anything for a big bass amplifier, you know, subwoofer that's going to take some power too. Like I said, we like them a lot here, and if you guys have any questions about anything Rockford, again, give us a call 302-5588. Thank you. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to introduce you guys to the brand Rydeen. They're actually a local company to us. They're based in Torrance, right down the street. What they're known for is vehicle safety. So they're known for backup cameras, blind spot detection. They even make replacement mirrors and secondary screens to interface cameras. So for you guys that don't have an additional screen or don't want to change the radio, we still have a solution for you. That being said, they're well known throughout the industry. They're some of the highest rated cameras on the market. They're also one of the smallest and most discreet as well. Cameras are very small and compact, about the size of a penny. Very small, image quality is very good on them. We actually match these things up with the Kenwood's new doubled in, the HD doubled in. So they're Exelon DNX 995 and the DDX 9905S, perfect match for these cameras, very high res. They also have built-in grid lines in a lot of the cameras. But they have tons of different camera styles. So they have the super wide, the standard active parking lines that'll emulate the turn-in lines that you see on a lot of the factory cars. They have the Duo 2, which is a double mounting camera. You can mount it top down or just regular like you see there. The keyhole cam, so you can flush it in different places, as well as the lip camera. They also have a universal bracket too, the BL01. That's gonna be the behind the license plate bracket. They also have a part number JB01, which is the Jeep bracket, which definitely made it a game changer for you guys that have factory wheels on your Jeeps. We can add a camera to it, make it look nice from the factory, hides right behind the factory tire, gives you a perfect view. Well, that's it, guys, from Tyler from Allen Eds. Again, introduce you guys to Rydeen, great company, local company. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds here to talk to you guys about the Rydeen CMD700, which is going to be the dual side camera kit. Let me show you what's going on. You're going to see the factory like housing. You can actually see there's actually a little tool in there that you can actually turn the cameras to get them to face different ways. It actually has an input box for left and right, as you can see labeled there, and just runs it into a single input. What's cool about this is the side cameras actually only take up one input, so you can actually run a left and right turn signal, or just a left and right side camera and a rear camera with a dual camera input. If you guys have any questions about this, you know Rydeen's the best, comes with a 3-year warranty. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. What's up, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds here to talk to you guys about the PSR 4000 4 sensor Rydeen backup sensor kit. This kit can actually be used as a front or rear kit. We normally just use them for rear, but let me show you what's going on. It's a universal kit too, so it'll work with any vehicle. But first and foremost, you're gonna notice the brain, and you're gonna notice 8 inputs. Again, we can actually order 4 more sensors and do it for the front if you guys want as well too. You got the power and the display. Most of the time when we do the install, we don't do the display, but this is what the display looks like. This is the display right here. Like I said, it's gonna display obviously green, yellow, red in the middle, let you know how close you're getting different things. Here's gonna be the speaker as well. Again, we hide that up just so you don't see it, obviously. But it does come with the speaker, that's how you're gonna be able to hear it. And here are the four sensors. What we like to do that's a little different from us compared to a lot of shops is we actually like sending out the sensors to get paint matched, just so it's gonna come out as factory as possible. Like I said, this kit's a really nice kit from our local neighbors at Rydeen. It's a really nice piece. You're gonna see all the harnesses and extensions, nothing really all that exciting down there. But like I said, this is a really nice piece from Rydeen. We use them a lot, pretty big. A lot of people are still asking to add parking sensors to their newer vehicles that already have cameras. This is gonna be the perfect solution for you guys. Again, from Rydeen, the PSR 4000 four sensor kit. If you guys have any questions about this piece, give us a call, 330-542-5588. Thanks, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about the SV747HD from Rydeen. If you guys have been following our Instagram page, you guys have definitely seen this thing before. It's the full, truly 7-inch HD unit from Rydeen. Let me show you what we got. Looks like just a standard mirror. A little bit bulkier, a little bit thicker. Comes with the standard tombstone, and we have other pieces that's going to make it fit in most vehicles. It actually has a speaker on the back, too. But like I said, you can see where the screen starts right there. You can see the buttons. You see the home button, up and down, mode button, power button, and the star selection button. So like I said, a few different things there. You can see what I was talking about with the universal tombstone there. So in cars that don't even come with them, we could even add it. This is going to be the switching system like I was talking about. So you can run it just as a straight input as well as do the switcher. This is going to be the proprietary plug. So you're going to see that the camera is going to be red. Then we're going to go from here. That's a pretty nice piece, guys. Great solution for anybody trying to add a backup camera.
Death like fur coats in Miami. I throw you a bone like rappers get Grammys. When I was feeling obsolete, I got an upgrade. So tell me what's my motherfucking name? We're booted. I make it hot like a jacuzzi. No time for a good girl, baby. I need a floozy. Break it down straight if y'all ain't getting this. Hard like all my blunt, my style is blend different. I'm stepping to the mic when I'm getting that itch. Then I shut it down like a main power switch. Get funky as hell like a polecat spray. So tell me what's the name again, kid? Damn right, I get you going like a green light. Gun it, got you shaking your head to disbelief like who done it. Don't need Richard Roundtree to solve this mystery. The name is Tyreen, hell yeah, the rest is history. I'm a great wonder like the pyramids of Giza. Never sold my soul like my name is Condoleezza. Took this day to Mexico thanks to free trade. They was like, como se llamas? That's words of my fam, the impossible's a lowdown. Like tumbleweeds at 12 o'clock noon, it's a showdown. My pen and my notebook strapped right to my hip. I put it between your eyes when I shoot the gift. You know I'm a fly guy, this you can't dispute. I'm rhyming for the love and I'm rhyming for the loot. I'll be the life of the party, wearing a lampshade. God damn it, what's my name?
Tyreen.
Yeah, let it ring out from block to block.
Tyreen.
It's that cold stank funk.
What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Want to talk to you guys about SiriusXM. I know we've talked about them in the past with some of our radio upgrades, or just talking about them in general, or with the Viaz tuning upgrade. But we're going to talk about the standalone ones. Best-selling piece here is going to be the SXV300 add-on tuner. This is going to be applicable to any radio that's SiriusXM ready, singled-in, doubled-in, or again, those Viaz tuners. But we also have standalone units from the Commander and the Onyx, too. Like I said, both these pieces are going to be great pieces that are going to go through either FM mod or they're going to go through factory auxiliary. We use these in a lot of vehicles that have factory radios. Like I said, with the Commander, it's going to be a touch screen, a little bit smaller. We actually, if you go on our Instagram, you can check out a lot of the pictures. We've actually flushed this bad boy in. The Onyx, we normally put them up on the dash. What's cool about the Onyx is it gives you the 10 presets on the front where you actually be able to cycle through numerous stations. A lot of the customers that come in here tell me that they don't have more than 6, 7, 8 presets. But if you have a factory radio and you want to keep it factory, we got solutions for you too, guys. Thanks again, guys. If you have any questions about anything serious, give us a call, 330-542-5588. Thanks, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds here to talk about the 8-gauge 4000 series power kit. It's going to support up to 600 watts, which is going to be 60 amps. You're going to notice that it actually comes pre-terminated with a battery connect as well as a ground. Gives you black and red. Obviously, red's going to be power, black's going to be ground. Gives you a nice fuse holder over here. It's going to be a glass mount style. 8 gauge. It's going to support most amplifiers. It's a very basic entry-level kit that's real copper, so something that you definitely don't have to worry about longevity-wise. Something that we carry in-house, guys. If you guys have any questions about anything Stinger, give us a call. 310-542-558. Thanks, guys. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about the PXE0850S. It's Alpine's new processor. We've done a lot of processors here at Allen Eds South Bay. We've done the Rockford 360 series. We've done Focal's processor. We've done a lot of stuff from Audison. This is by far our favorite processor, and at the price point, I think it's probably the best on the market too. Let's open this bad boy up. It has a separate controller, so this is gonna be the cable for that. The instructions and stuff like that. Right there, guys, again, that's the Alpine processor. It's got three RCA inputs as well as high level input. You can also actually run Bluetooth streaming straight into it. You can also run optical and SPDIF. The other thing you can also do, well, it also has six RCA pre-outs, and it'll also do high level as well too, and SPDIF out. The nice thing about this piece, again, is the price point. It's got Bluetooth built in with a separate chip. I'll show you guys that right now. You don't have to use it. It's gonna be the plug back here. But yeah, you can use it, you don't have to use it. It's a nice standalone piece you can flush in the dash. Here's that Bluetooth streaming chip, and actually you'll see us plug it in right now. Like I said, the other nice thing about it too is you can use this as a source, you can use this as a standalone, you can use this as a radio replacement. Alpine actually came out with their own first 8-inch woofer with DSP built in with Bluetooth, so actually you can actually use that as an all-in-one audio upgrade. But like I said, this is Alpine's PXE0850S. It's going to be one of the best DSP on the markets for the price. Again, at a retail price point of $699, guys, you can't beat it. Give us a call, 310-542-5588. What's going on, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. I want to talk to you guys about this Trailblazer SS we outfitted with a full upgraded Alpine system to coexist with his existing Pioneer radio. So first and foremost, we have an SW10D4 here in the back quarter. One of the things you're going to notice is we actually went past the plastic and actually used the inner fender's airspace, so we didn't lose much, if actually any, trunk space whatsoever. The one thing that was back there was a little pocket, as well as the Trailblazer SS actually comes with a tire inflator and deflator. So like I said, instead of actually losing that, we actually cut it and relocated it, extended all the wires so it actually fit over here, so it's actually even easier to get to. The other thing I wanted to show you guys too is the amplifier. It's got a PDR V75 Alpine amplifier, 5-channel as well. It's actually about 100 watts all the way around and 350, quote unquote, to the sub. Actually definitely sees a little bit more wattage than that. Besides that, we actually put a Rydene Duo 3 HD camera as well too. I like it, it's got a true metal housing, just like anything Rydene. It comes with a 3-year warranty. It's really nice about this location. It looks factory, gives you access to see the bumper as well too, so you can, you know, line it up just about anywhere. Show you what on the inside what that guidelines look like. So first things first, drop this thing in reverse. You're gonna see the display, and like I said, with the Rydene, you're actually gonna be able to see the bumper and everything. Besides that, this thing's got Apple CarPlay. It's about a year old now, but it's got, or 2 years old now. It's got Apple CarPlay, but also besides that, you can force the camera on. So even when you're in, I'm in park right now, but if you were to drop it and drive, it'll still stay on here. So at any point in time, you can see behind you, which is pretty cool. Besides that PDR V75 you see in the back, it'll actually have an SS65C in the front and SS65s in the rear. Like I said, pretty cool unit still, even though it doesn't match 100%, but customer's really happy with this unit.
All right, welcome back. We're on our way to tint Travis Barker's car. Got the van all loaded up and we're taking off. Here we are outside Travis Barker's house, getting ready to tune his Mercedes. Super excited to get here. Alright, here we are getting ready to get started on tinting this Mercedes G-Wagon for Travis Barker. Really excited, this is a sweet car.
Looking forward to making it look better, even better, with some nice dub IR window film.
Alright, just finished up tinting Travis Barker's Mercedes. Came out really good, 20% dub IR all the way around with 50 on the windshield. Definitely one of my favorite jobs to work on.
Thank you, Alameda South Bay. G-Wagon, much love.
What's up, guys? Tyler from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about the VSM 550 from Viper / Directed. It's going to be their tracking solution that we add on to any of the Viper alarms. It'll do vehicle tracking. You can lock and unlock your car. You can remote start it as well, too. It's actually really convenient. Let's open this bad boy up. Let's see what it looks like. This is actually what the VSM 550 looks like. What's cool about it, too, is it can actually be used as a universal piece to just track, or you can use it in conjunction with a Viper alarm that you can, again, do the unlock, lock, remote start, trunk pop. You can actually set up smart fencing too. So basically whenever the car is parked, you can set up a geotag and a geofence for, you know, a couple blocks, quarter mile, half mile, mile. When it breaks that tag, it'll send you an alert to your phone. Perfect for like if you have kids that are new drivers, you don't want them driving after certain times, you can put the car on lockdown. If that car moves, it'll actually let you know. Like I said, guys, if you are interested in anything from tracking to just this VSM 550 in conjunction with aftermarket alarm or standalone, give us a call, 310-542-5588. Thanks, guys. What's going on, guys? Tal from Allen Eds. Wanted to talk to you guys about Alpine's ILX 107. Very popular unit when they first came out. They're kind of getting a second wave too. $699 unit, wireless CarPlay enabled unit. It's going to do AM FM radio as well as auxiliary Bluetooth and CarPlay. See all the wires and everything labeled there. You got the USB connection. Just because all the wireless CarPlay units still can be hardwired in, so you still can plug in to do CarPlay. You don't have to do it wirelessly, so it'll still charge the phone. Here's the unit right here, guys. So again, just pretty much wireless CarPlay, wired CarPlay, AM, FM, as well as Bluetooth and auxiliary. Also has a rear camera input as well too. But like I said, really nice unit, guys. We sell a lot of them, really happy with them. Kind of getting their second wave back in. It's about a year old now at this point, but 107, 207 Alpine units are still doing really good, guys. Thanks again.